Hi friends, now we are discussing review of the higher order linear differential equations. Okay, you see friends, an equation is of the form a naught of x d to the power of ny by dx power n plus a1 of x into d power ny by dx power n plus so on an of x into y is equal to q of x is called linear differential equation of order n, where a naught of x is not equal to 0. Okay, you see friends, if n is equal to 1, then you can say it is a linear differential equation. Okay, suppose if n is 1, then you can say a naught of x, here you will have a naught of x into dy by dx plus a1 of x into y equal to q of x form is called a first order and first degree linear differential equation. If n is greater than 1, then you can say higher order linear differential equations. In the previous videos, we discussed about the first order and first degree linear differential equation. Now we are discussing higher order, nothing but n is greater than 1, right? N greater than 1. Now these are different types. Here you see a0, a1, a1, a0 of x, a1 of x, so on, an of x are there. If these all are the constants, then you can say this is linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Okay, if a naught of x, a1 of x, so on, an of x are all are the constant, then you can say this is a linear differential equation with the constant coefficients. For example, I am giving examples. You see, this is y triple dash minus 2y double dash plus 3y is equal to 3y dash is equal to 0. This is a linear differential equation with the constant coefficients. One more example, you see, d square plus 2d plus 3 into y is equal to cos x. This is also linear differential equation with constant coefficient. One more example I am giving. You see, this is also, you can write d square y by dx square, okay, plus 3 into dy by dx plus 6 into y is equal to x square plus x plus 1. This is also examples of, you see, 6, 3, 1. The coefficient of y is 6, coefficient of dy by dx is 3, and d square y by dx square is 1. So all these are constants. So you can say this is linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So in this case, the q of x is either constant or variable. You see, the first case, this is a constant. Even though it is a constant or variables, then you can say this is a linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Next, another type we have, if a naught of x, a1 of x, so on, an of x, any one of them is a constant, any one of them is a variable, then you can say this linear differential equation is said to be variable coefficients. A naught of x, a1 of x, a2 of x, an of x, any one of them is a variable, then you can say that is a linear differential equation with a variable coefficient. Okay, now for example, may they will give like this. You see, x into d square y by dx square plus 2 into dy by dx is equal to sin x. You observe the dy by dx coefficient is 2 and d square y by dx square coefficient is x. So at least one of the constant here, at least one of an is variable, then you can say this is variable coefficient. So this is example of linear differential equation with variable coefficient. Next, one more example. You see, x square into d square plus x into d plus 2 times of y is equal to x plus 1. Friends, you see, here this is also called linear differential equation with variable coefficient. And one more example also I am giving, you see, that is 2x plus 3 whole square into d square y by dx square plus 2x plus 3 into dy by dx plus 5 is equal to cos x, if you have. Then this is also cos of, you can say, 2x plus 3. This is also an example of linear differential equation with a variable coefficients, right? Based on the order of the derivative and index of x, we can divide this linear differential equation with variable coefficient as two types. You see here, first type, the Cauchy-Euler equations. An equation is of the form a naught x to the power of n d power n y by dx power n, a1 x power n minus 1 d power n minus 1 by dx power n plus so on an into y is equal to q of x. Friends, here a0, a1, an, so an, like all are here constants. Maybe q of x is either constant or variable. But here you observe the coefficient of d power n y by dx power n, what I have? A0 x power n. The index of x is n. Order of the derivative is n. In this case, index of x is n minus 1. order of the derivative is n minus 1. Here index of x is 1, order of the derivative is 1. Here is there any x term? No, so x power 0. And what about the order of the derivative? D power 0. Nothing but in each term of this differential equation, order of the derivative and index of x is equal. Okay, so this one you can say homogeneous linear differential equation or simply Euler-Cauchy equations. For example, so you see I am giving some examples for this. X square d square plus 2xd plus 3 into y is equal to cos x. One more example. X cube d cube minus 2x square d square plus 5xd minus 2 into y is equal to 0. So these are examples of the Cauchy-Euler equation, because d square quotient is x square. Index of x and order of the derivative. Index of x, order of the derivative same. Here also index of x is 3, order of the derivative is 3. Index of x is 2, order of the derivative is 2. Index of x is 1, order of the derivative is 1. So you can say these are examples of the Cauchy-Euler equations. Next, another model. An equation, a linear differential equation is of the form a naught into a plus bx whole power n into d power n y by dx power n. A1 into a plus bx whole power n minus 1 d power n minus 1 y by dx power n minus 1. So on an minus 1 into a plus bx whole to the power of 1 dy by dx plus an into y is equal to q of x. Here a0, a1, so on, an, all are constant. Q of x is either constant or it may be a variable of x alone. So in this case you observe the order of derivative is what? N. And what about the index of a plus bx here? N. Here a plus bx index is n minus 1. Order of the derivative is n minus 1. So in each and every term of this differential equation, the index of a plus bx and order of the derivative is same. So you can say this differential equation is said to be Legendre's linear equations. Okay, Legendre linear equations. Now we have to solve these type of the problems in this unit. Friends, you see, first type what we have? Linear differential equation with the constant coefficients. Next type, second one, linear differential equation with the variable. In this variable quotients, we are divided like two parts in this unit especially. That is Cauchy-Euler homogeneous differential equation. Another one is Legendre's linear differential equations we have. Okay, so how to solve these type of the differential equations means we have to introduce the new variable, that is operator form. We have to convert into operator form. That operator we are denoting with the D. Operator we are denoting with the D. D is nothing but here D by DX. Okay, now I will explain how to solve these type of the problems. See, a0 of x d power n y by dx power n, and a1 of x d power n minus 1 by dx power n minus 1 plus so on, an of x into y is equal to q of x is called a linear differential equation with constant coefficients if a0, a1, so on, an, all are constants. Right, now we have to introduce the operator, that is d. We are denoting with d by dx. If you apply this one, you see dy we are denoting with dy by dx. Okay, now it can be written as a0 of x into d power n y plus a1 of x into d power n minus 1 y plus so on plus an of x into y is equal to q of x. Okay, now from this you can take y is a common, then a0 of x into d to the power of n plus a1 of x into, okay, it is a constant, so treat this is a constant, even I have written x. Okay, d power n minus 1 y plus so on plus an of x into an of x, here I took y as a common term, into q of x. Now you observe this is in the form of f of d into y is equal to q of x. Operator form f of d into y is equal to q of x. Now the general solution of f of d into y is equal to q of x is we have y of x is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Complementary function plus a particular integral. Now we have to find out the complementary function. How we can find out the complementary function for f of d into y is equal to q of x means we have to introduce the new variable, that is let y is equal to e power mx be a solution of f of d into y is equal to 0. While finding the complementary function, we are taking right side part q of x is 0 and we are considering y is equal to e power mx. In this case, you see derivative of y is equal to e power mx derivative m into e to the power of mx. D square y is equal to m into e power mx derivative is e power mx into m. So m square e power mx. Similarly, d to the power of n y is equal to, you will have m to the power of m, m to the power of n into e power mx. If you are substituted these all values in f a naught of x, in this one if you are substituted, then we will get auxiliary equation, you see, like this form: a naught m to the power of n a1 m power m minus 1 plus so on plus an into e to the power of mx is equal to 0. So product of the two functions are 0 in this case. Then either any one of them 0 or both will be 0. In this case e power mx never 0. So which is 0 now? A naught of a naught into m power m, a1 into m power n minus 1 plus so on plus an is equal to 0. So now it is in the form of f of m is equal to 0. Algebraic polynomial of degree n. So f of m is equal to 0. Then you will get the roots for this equation. Based on the roots only, we will write the complementary function. Friends, the roots of the differential equation, roots of this equation, you may get real roots or complex roots also. Okay. Now, if the roots are real and distinct, like you see, A, B, C are the roots. Three roots, these are real and distinct. Then you will have the complementary function is C1 e power AX plus C2 e power BX plus C3 e power CX. For example, you see, 1 comma 2 comma 3 are the roots. 1 1 2 3, let it be minus 1, negative also I am taking. Minus 1 2 comma 3 are the roots. These are real or not? Real and distinct. So what you can write a complementary function, you see, C1 e power A, what is A here? Minus 1. So C1 e power minus X plus C2 e power BX, what is B? 2X plus C3 e power 3X. Okay, next one more example, that is, if you have like a 0 comma minus 2 comma 5, if you have, then 5 by 2 also. Okay, because real means you may get a 5 by 2. Okay, now in this case the complementary function is equal to C1 e power 0x plus C2 e power minus 2x plus C3 e power 5 by 2 times of x, nothing but 5x by 2. Friends, in this case the roots are real and distinct. Is it clear for everyone how to write if the roots are real and distinct complementary function? Now the roots may be sometimes repeated. Okay, suppose d cube is equal to 0 is there, m cube equal to 0, nothing but m is equal to 0 comma 0 comma 0. Sometimes m minus 1 whole cube equal to 0, so m is equal to 1 comma 1 comma 1. Sometimes m cube into m minus 1 equal to 0. So in that case you may get the roots 0 comma 0 comma 0 comma 1 are the roots. So sometimes the roots may be repeated. If roots are repeated, then how to write? You see, if a comma a comma a are the roots are repeated 3 times, okay, and b is a non-repeated root, these all are real. Okay, then in this case which is repeated here? A is repeated. How many times it is repeated? 3 times it is repeated. So you have to write polynomial expression form, that is c y of x is equal to c1 plus c2 x plus c3 x square into, which is repeated? A is repeated 3 times, so e power ax. Suppose if a is repeated twice, then you have to write c1 plus c2 x into e power ax. Okay, if it is 4 times repeated, then c1 plus c2 x plus c3 x square plus c4 x cube also will come. Sometimes you see roots are like 2 comma 2 minus 3 comma minus 3. Here in this case 4 roots are there, 2 roots are repeated twice. In this case how to write? You see, first I am writing this one, ycf is equal to, in this case 0 is repeated how many times? 3 times. So you have to write polynomial expression, that is c0, okay, let it be c1 plus c2x plus c3x square, okay, into e to the power of, which is repeated? 0. So 0x plus, which is non-repeated here? Only you have only one, that is a fourth one. So c4 into e power 1x, that's it. Next, second one, you see 2 comma 2 is repeated how many times? 2 times. So write down c1 plus c2x, that's it. Because 2 times it is repeated, 3 times means you will write this one, 4th time means c4x cube you will write. Now which is repeated? 2. So e power 2x. Sir, here this minus 3 is also repeated 2 times. So will you write next what you have to write means? You have to write same like c1 plus c2x form only. But already c1 comma c2 are repeated. So c1 comma c2 are existing. So you write down another 2 arbitrary constant, because how many roots are there? 4 roots. So you will get 4 arbitrary constants. So c1 c2 completed. Now I am considering as a c3. So c3 plus c4 into e to the power of minus 3x. sometimes you may get a doubt, sir, one can I write like c1 e power x first? Yes, you can write c1 e power x first, later c2 plus c3 x plus c4 x cube x square into e power 0 x you can write. Here also you can write c1 plus c2 x, this is x, c1 plus c2 x into e power minus 3 x plus c4 plus c3 plus c4 x into e power 2 x also. Clear? Next, complex roots. Friends, you see, sometimes you may get a complex roots like this, a plus r minus b a, where a is a real part of the number and b is imaginary part of this number. Then you will let e power ax into c1 cos bx plus c2 sin bx. Sometimes these complex roots also may be repeated. Sometimes you may get a complex roots and a real roots also. In that case, how you will write? For example, you see friends, here you have 2 plus r minus 3i, comma 5 is there. So here the roots are complex roots and real root is there. So cf I am writing first real root, c1 e power 5x, completed, one root is completed. Next, 2 plus r minus 3i is in the form of a plus r minus bi. So what you are writing? E power ax. What is a here? 2. So e power 2x into here bi, if it is there, c1 cos bx plus c2 sin bx you are writing. So write on b is here 3. So c1 cos 3x plus c2 sin 3x. That's it. Okay. Is it clear for everyone? When the complex root is came and real root is also added. Sometimes complex roots may be repeated like 2 plus minus 2 plus r minus 3i by 5. Let it be. Okay. These are repeated twice. Minus 2 plus r minus 3i by 5. Then in this case, we have to separate a plus r minus bi form. What is the a here? Minus 2 by 5 is a, and b is equal to 3 by 5 only. The coefficient of I is b here, not 3i. Okay. Now in this case, you see ycf. Here it is repeated. Whenever repeated is came, you need to write c1 plus c2x. You see, c1 plus c2x into, here you see, first, here actually we need to write real part is there. Whenever a complex number a plus r minus b is there, we are writing e power ax. I will write in last step. Okay. Next, c1 cos bx. What is the b here? 3 by 5. So cos 3 by 5x plus another term, c3 plus c4x into sin 3 by 5x into e to the power of ax. What is a here? I have minus 2 by 5. X. Is it clear for everyone? Now I am repeating again. You see, whenever the complex roots are repeated in this case, then we will write down e power ax into c1 plus c2x into cos bx. So separate a. A is equal to, a is here 2 by 5. Which 2 by 5? Negative 2 by 5. B is equal to I quotient, that is 3 by 5. Okay. Now e power ax into c into, here you have only one root? No, roots are repeated. So c1 plus c2x into cos bx plus c3 plus c4x into sin bx. Is it clear for everyone how to write the complementary functions? Right. Next we will discuss the particular integral. Now we are completed a complementary function. So we are discussing particular integral. Friends, to find the particular integral, we have a different types. First one is general method. Friends, in the general method, suppose f of d into y is equal to q of x is there. Generally, particular integral we are denoting with 1 by f of d into q of x. So this f of d we have to write in linear factors, and we need to use this formula. You see friends, d plus a into q of x if you have, because f of d, suppose higher order linear differential equation, we have to write into product of the linear terms. That is 1 by d plus a into q of x is equal to e power minus ax into integral of q of x into e to the power of ax dx. This formula we are using to solve the general method. Okay. Briefly we are discussing. Later we will solve the more number of the problems on the general method. Now, second method, shortcut method we have. Friends, whenever the q of x, based on the q of x, we have a shortcut method. When you can apply shortcut method means, if q of x is equal to first constant k, okay, whenever k is there, we are replacing d, whenever constant is there, we are replacing d is equal to 0, failure, this is, next, whenever k constant is completed, next, if it is in the form of exponential function, e power ax, Next, a to the power of x also, we can apply shortcut method. Next, either sin ax or cos ax is there, we can apply shortcut method. Next, here x to the power of n is there, we can apply shortcut method. Polynomial expression like 1 plus x square is there, we can apply shortcut method. Next, e power ax into v of x, this v of x is either sin or cos or polynomial also, okay. Next one, x to the power of m into v of x form. So x power m into v of x means that may be sin ax or cos ax or e power ax. If e power ax is there, better to use e power ax into v of x method. If sin ax or cos ax, then we can apply this method, right? These all are we will discuss in the next videos in detail, okay? Next, shortcut method we can apply for these all the problems. Next, we have a special method. That method is said to be variation of parameter method. Variation of parameters. Parameter method. Friends, this variation of parameter method we will apply for the first order and higher order also. Okay, first order and higher order also. Now, I am explaining variation of parameter method. Friends, first order and higher order we can apply this one, but in generally they are giving in the exam point of view, especially second order only they are giving, right? How to solve the second order linear differential equation if they are given by using variation of parameter. This variation of parameter method we can apply for the linear differential equation with variable quotient as well as constant quotient also. Okay, you see friends, if it is the given differential equation in this form, the second order linear differential equation where a naught of x is not is equal to 0, a naught of x is not is equal to 0, then we have to convert into nothing but we have to divide a naught of x entire equation, divide with a naught of x entire equation, then we will have d square y by dx square plus p of x into dy by dx plus q of x into y equal to r of x. What is p of x means? We are dividing with a naught of x, so a1 of x by a naught of x, a1 of x by a naught of x is p of x. Similarly, a2 of x by a naught of x, a2 of x by a naught of x is q of x, and this is q of x by, suppose it is a3 of x, let it be a3 of x, then a3 of x by a naught of x is called r of x. Is it clear for everyone? So this is a3 of x. Please consider a3 of x. Now it is a standard form of second order linear differential equation. Then how to find the solution means, friends, for this also we have a general solution, y of x is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. But there is a special consideration is there, that is to find the particular integral we use complementary function only. This, what is the order of the differential equation is here? 2 only. So generally you will get the complementary function is in the form of c1 u of x plus c2 v of x. Earlier we have discussed the complementary functions, yes or no? Like suppose a comma b is there, we are writing c1 e power ax plus c2 e to the power of bx. Suppose if you have like a plus or minus b, c1 cos bx plus c2 sin bx, we are writing, yes or no? So c1 u of x plus c2 v of x, here also c1 u of x plus c2 v of x form. So this is the general this is the complementary function we are writing. Now we have to find the particular integral. How we can find out means, replace c1 by a and c2 by b. Now we have to find out a of x and b of x, that's it. How you can find out a of x and b of x means, we have a of x is equal to minus v r dx by w of x. V means this is a v, and r of x means here you have. What about the w of x? W of x is called Wronskian of u comma v. Wronskian of u comma v, we are denoting with u, v, u dash, v dash. Friends, this Wronskian is not equal to 0 because u of x and v of x are the linearly independent solutions. Now we will apply we will substitute v value, r value and w value, then you will get a of x. Similarly, b of x is equal to, we have formula u into r by w of x. U is equal to, u is nothing but c1 quotient, and r is in the problem what they are given right side part, and w is Wronskian. If you have substituted these all values in b, then you will have b of x. Now in this case you have a of x and b of x values, substitute in particular integral, then we will have the particular integral. Now the general solution is complementary function plus particular integral. So these are the methods we have to solve the linear differential equation with the constant quotients. Constant quotient only, not for variable quotient. Friends, if it is a variable quotient, we cannot solve directly. Whenever the variable quotients, if they are given, then we have to convert into constant quotients. Okay, what are the variable quotients we have? We have two types of the variable quotients. One is Legendre polynomial equations, another one is Cauchy-Euler equations. Now, Cauchy-Euler equation, if you are applied operator form, then it will be in the form of a0 x power n d power n, a1 x power n minus 1 d power n minus 1 plus 1 an only an into y is equal to q of x. Okay, now to solve this variable equation, first we have to, this is a variable equation form or not, linear differential equation with variable equation, we have to convert into constant equation. How you can convert into constant equation means we have to introduce a new variable z, where z is equal to log x, then x is equal to, you will have e to the power of z. Friends, you see here the differential equation operator form, we have a d is nothing but d by dx. But here you observe in the Cauchy-Euler equation, the order of the derivative and the index of x is same. Nothing but you will have like xd terms, xd, x square, d square, so on, x to the power of n, d power n form. Now we have to convert into another variable. This d is nothing but differentiation with respect to z, differentiation with respect to x. Now we have to convert this one with respect to differentiation with respect to z. How you can convert means, you see, xd we can write as a theta, where theta is nothing but d by dz. Next, x square d square is equal, we will write as theta into theta minus 1. X cube d cube is equal to theta into theta minus 1 into theta minus 2. Okay, now we have to substitute these all values in the above equation. These are the problems and method I will explain in the next videos. Now I am giving briefly only to complete this concept, right? Now, these all values you substitute in this equation. Then we will have the polynomial equation is in the form of f of theta into y is equal to q of z form. Now, we will get the general solution like y of x is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. We have to do like previous methods only. In this case, you will get the complementary function in terms of z. Now, we have to replace z by log x. And particular integral also you will get in terms of z. Now, we have to replace z by log x. If x is there, e power z is there, we are replacing x. Suppose e power 2z is there, 2z is there, we are writing x to the power of n. E power nz is there, we are writing as x power n. Okay. Now, this entire solution will be converted as y of x only. Y of x is equal, we will write a complementary function plus particular integral. This is the Cauchy-Euler equation. Next, we have Legendre linear equation. We know that the Legendre equation is of the form a0 plus a plus bx whole to the power of n into d to the power of n plus so on plus an into y is equal to q of x form we have. So, in this case, how we can convert into variable equation? This variable equation, linear differential equation with variable equation to constant equation means we are introducing a plus bx is equal to, this is z is equal to log of a plus bx. We are writing z is equal to log of a plus bx, which is implies a plus bx is equal to e to the power of z we have. Okay, from this also we can get x value in terms of z. Now we have to replace this. You observe the index of a plus bx and order of the derivative is same in the Legendre linear differential equations. Okay, now we are replacing z is equal to log of a plus bx. Similarly, we are replacing actually d is nothing but d by dx we have. Now we are changing x in terms of z, so derivative also we have to change in terms of z. How you can change means a plus bx into dy we are writing as b into theta y. Next, a plus bx whole square into d square we are writing as b square into theta minus 1. Next, a plus bx whole cube into d cube is equal to b cube into theta minus 1 into theta minus 2. So, these all values we are substituting in the above equation. Then we will have f of theta into y is equal to q of z form. Hence, the final solution we will have y of z is equal to complementary function plus particular integral, because this is in terms of z. Finally, we are replacing z by log of a plus bx. Then you will have the general solution is y of x is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So z is changed in terms of x. So like this we have to do entire, like this we can solve the higher order linear differential equation with a constant quotient and a variable question. I have solved many number of the problems on this topic. Okay, right. Thank you for watching this video.